We'll predict the products of two different reactions. Our first reaction will have balanced charges, and the other will have unbalanced charges. Hello everyone, I'm Melissa Maribel, your personal tutor, and let's look at the trick for predicting products of double replacement reactions. Always start with combining the inner elements together, where the positive charge, which is the metal, always goes first, and the negative charge, which is the nonmetal or polyatomic ion, goes second. Note, this 2 subscript was only there to balance out aluminum and sulfate's charges. And this 3 subscript was only there to balance out calcium and phosphate's charges, so the 2 and the 3 subscripts do not come down when we are predicting the product. Instead, we just look at the calcium and sulfate with their typical charges. Since the charges are the same, we do not have to add any additional subscript. So our first product is this. Now we'll combine the outer elements together, where again, the positive charge goes first, then the negative charge. We will combine aluminum and phosphate together, and their charges are also the same, so this is our second product. And this is our overall unbalanced equation. All right, here's the trickier reaction. We will approach it the same way, where the inner elements combine, and we place the positive charge first, then the negative charge. Again, note that this 2 subscript was only there to balance out calcium and chlorine's charges. And this 3 subscript was only there to balance out sodium and phosphate. So the 2 and 3 subscripts do not come down when we are predicting the product. Instead, we look at just the single elements of sodium and chlorine with their typical charges, which form our first product. Now we'll combine the outer elements together, where again, the positive charge goes first, then the negative charge. We will combine calcium and phosphate together, and their charges are not the same. Whenever your charges are not the same, you must put a subscript to balance out the charges. The charge of phosphate is now calcium's new subscript, and the charge of calcium is now phosphate's new subscript. So this is our product. And this is our overall unbalanced equation. Where are you going? We still have to know how to balance chemical equations, so click right over here. And remember, stay determined, you can do this.